Have you ever wondered if a simple text box on a website could be a gateway to an entire database? Imagine typing a few characters and suddenly having access to the usernames, passwords, and credit card details of thousands of users. Sounds like science fiction? Welcome to the world of SQL injection attacks, where a few cleverly placed quotation marks can bring an entire system to its knees. In today's journey through the realm of ethical hacking, we're diving deep into SQL injection attacks, a powerful technique that has been compromising databases and haunting developers for decades. Let's start with a scenario. You're on an e-commerce website, searching for a product. You type blue shirt into the search box and hit enter. Behind the scenes, the website constructs an SQL query to fetch relevant products from its database. But what if, instead of blue shirt, you type something a little more mischievous? This is the essence of an SQL injection attack. It exploits vulnerabilities in the way an application constructs database queries. By injecting malicious SQL code into input fields, an attacker can manipulate the query, potentially gaining unauthorized access to the entire database. Now, let's break down how this attack works. Imagine a simple login form on a website. When you enter your username and password, the application might construct an SQL query like this. Select from users where username input underscore username and password input underscore password. Seems innocent enough, right? But what if an attacker entered this as the username or 1 is equal to 1? Now our query looks like this. Select from users where username or 1 is equal to 1 and password input underscore password. See what happened? The or 1 is equal to 1 part is always true, effectively bypassing the password check. Suddenly, the attacker has access to the first user account in the database, which is often an administrator account. But SQL injection isn't just about bypassing logins. It can be used to read sensitive data from the database, modify database content, execute administration operations on the database, issue commands to the operating system, and in some cases, even take control of the server hosting the database. Let's explore some more advanced techniques. First, we have union-based SQL injection. This technique uses the union SQL operator to combine the results of two or more select statements. An attacker can use this to retrieve data from different database tables. Next, there's blind SQL injection. This is used when the application is vulnerable to SQL injection, but the results are not displayed to the attacker. It's like trying to pick a lock while blindfolded. The attacker has to ask the database a series of true-false questions and deduce the answers based on the application's response. Then we have time-based SQL injection. This is a type of blind SQL injection where the attacker can deduce if the injection was successful based on the time the database takes to respond. It's like determining if a safe is unlocked by how long it takes to turn the handle. Now, you might be wondering, why are SQL injection attacks so dangerous? There are several reasons. First, they can lead to unauthorized access to sensitive data. An attacker could potentially access, modify, or delete any data in the database. Second, they can compromise data integrity. An attacker could insert, update, or delete records, potentially causing significant damage to the business. Third, they can lead to complete system compromise. In some cases, SQL injection can be used to execute system commands on the database server. Lastly, they're surprisingly common. Despite being well known, SQL injection vulnerabilities continue to plague many web applications. So, how can we defend against these database whisperers? For developers, the first line of defense is input validation and sanitization. Never trust user input. Always validate and sanitize any data that comes from users before using it in SQL queries. Next, use parameterized queries or prepared statements. These separate the SQL logic from the data, making it much harder for an attacker to inject malicious code. Implementing the principle of least privilege is crucial. Database accounts used by applications should have the minimum privileges necessary to function. This limits the potential damage if an attack is successful. Regular security audits and penetration testing can help identify SQL injection vulnerabilities before attackers exploit them. For database administrators, keeping the database management system updated is essential. Many SQL injection techniques exploit known vulnerabilities in specific database systems. Using web application firewalls, WAF can provide an additional layer of protection. These can detect and block many common SQL injection attempts. For users, while SQL injection is primarily a problem for developers to solve, being cautious about the websites you trust with your data is always a good practice. If a website seems poorly maintained or unprofessional, it's more likely to have security vulnerabilities. As we wrap up, let's remember that while SQL injection attacks are a serious threat, they're not invincible. By understanding how these attacks work and implementing strong security practices, we can significantly reduce the risk of falling victim to these database whisperers. In our data-driven world, databases are the beating heart of most applications. Every search you perform, every login attempt, every online purchase potentially interacts with a database. SQL injection reminds us of the delicate balance between functionality and security, between trusting user input and protecting our systems. In our next video, we'll explore another fascinating concept in the world of ethical hacking. Until then, remember to validate your inputs, parameterize your queries, and never underestimate the power of a well-placed quotation mark. Stay curious, stay secure, and keep exploring the intricate world of cybersecurity.